Okay, everybody, so the small talk is going to be about the current status on new health and what do we need to work to for the next projects that we're having. For those that doesn't know about new health, it's the health information system and hospital management information system. It works at the three levels, so you have all the doctor-patient relationship with evaluations, lifestyle, and so on. Then you have the second part where Triton makes the big role, where it's a health and hospital information system. And finally, you deal with demographics, epidemiology, and so on. This is the infrastructure. And this is what it basically we wanted to do. We need the system to interoperate with other existing solutions on either the health center that you have or at Ministry of Health. This is why we started the project for small primary care centers. And then due to its modular design, we've been able to make it larger and larger for different institutions. We have, for example, the lab test, and now we see how we are going to be working. This is, and I take the opportunity now to introduce a new system that we call it Oculino. This is a lab information management system that is a general purpose information management system for Triton. That is, we used to have before a lab module for health, but now what we'll be doing is have Oculino that will take care of any sort of lab. That not necessarily is going to be related to health. It can be water, it can be food, and we have already some projects that have asked us for this type of solution. So in the upcoming versions of New Health, we will be linking the lab module to this general engine, which makes it much more scalable. Now, things that the Jamaica project is asking us, and this is where we kind of have the turning point, is we are dealing now with a national system. The Jamaica Ministry of Health has taken Triton and has taken New Health to implement it at the national level, both for primary care centers and for hospitals. So every person in Jamaica will have a health ID and it will be taken by Triton and by the set of modules called New Health. So, yeah, thank you guys. It's big. Yeah, we are very happy, we're very proud, but we also know that this is a huge project that is going to need, you know, the help of all of us to make it a reality. We are actually going to start with four large regional hospitals. Each of these regional hospitals will have different primary cares that will be connected to those. And then we'll have a master data database that will have all the information on it. So we need to sign digitally those encounters. We need to sign the prescriptions. They are going to be using electronic prescriptions. And also, we can encrypt sensitive data. We can encrypt the prescriptions themselves. We can encrypt the QR code that is going to be generated for the patient ID. And for all of that, we need a CA, we need a PKI. The other thing that we will be integrating is HL7, that's a messaging system, so it will make it communicate between different health centers. Kevin is an expert on that, so I rather don't say much about it. And we don't know whether to use the Python libraries or, as Cedric also has suggested, we might use a general purpose messaging system within Triton and then create different modules for different type of solutions. This is the other thing. They have required for mobile health professionals, call it nurses, call it social workers, people that is going to be on the go, they will be using tablets. So we need to, you know, keep updated the Android, in this case, client. And now Sebastian will be talking a little bit more about this. We will have a master database that will have the records of a party, a person itself. That person can be a doctor, any health professional, a patient. So we need to set up a way of synchronizing that unique ID. And that unique ID is not only the person itself, but the clinical history that they have, the encounter history, the meds, and we have to make sure that when he goes from this hospital to this hospital, that information has already been updated on that master database. Of course, we will have some sort of independence on each of these hospitals. For example, Stock might be one of them. Stock might be managed at a hospital level. It doesn't really need to go here if we need. But the patient will have to be unique, and that information has to be always updated, no matter at which health center they go. That's the other thing that we want to do. We know that there are a lot of mistakes done when you are taking notes from, you know, electrocardiograms, from blood pressure takings, and so on. So we are taking some propositions of including Arduino into NuHealth, which is done, of course, at the nursing most of the time. But you can also have it at the intensive care units when you are dealing with electrocardiograms. Whether to keep using this method of DICOM client, where basically at NuHealth level we have a link of the DICOM DIR information and we just see it, or should we work with native DICOM libraries and include it within the client itself? Early warning systems, we talked a bit before that, but here we are also doing the georeferencing. This is already done, but we will also would like to integrate it with that epidemiology engine or business intelligence engine that will allow us to know, hey, you know what, here is a breakout of dengue, here is a breakout of TB or whatever, and let us know exactly where is that happening. And we already talked about this. We need to work with Baby as the system to aggregate data and have reporting in a better way than not static as we were doing up to this point. And this is still where we are dealing with the development environment. We are using everything on Savannah with Mercurial. The documentation effort is trying to be done at the Wikibook. And TransFX is the portal to translation. And that's pretty much it. We will be at the WHO Global Forum on Medical Devices in a couple of weeks, and hope to see you there. Thank you.
ID? What is there a plan or an idea for, say, somebody from another country comes in and they receive health care, but they have a medical history somewhere else? Is your system, what would you need to talk to the other system or bring in the information and keep it?
Well, the patient master record already has alternative IDs. So when you create that, you will have a unique ID, and then you will have, for example, say your passport number from Spain, okay? But that information will go to the master record. It doesn't matter your nationality. You will have a number at that point in time, and even if you are an undocumented being, you will also generate that number. Then with the time being, if that information is given, if you survive, and someone comes and tells you, okay, this is the actual information, you will put it there. Because you see it many times. You see many times that someone ran into an accident, in a car accident, and they come to the office and they won't have any ID on them. Then you check them as an NN, and then, again, I mean, you see it in, even you don't really have to run into an accident. In many countries, there are people that doesn't have IDs. They just don't exist in law. And they come to your health center and you take care of them, and you will assign an ID. Similarly as the newborn. The newborn is an entity that is some sort in a limbus until someone comes from the National Registration Office and say, okay, this is your national ID. But from that point that you are born until you get that official ID, you will get this number that will also be part of you, and that's the idea with this until you die.
Well, what about importation of known medical data? Someone comes from Spain and they have known medical history, but it's set up in another data format or something. How would you translate it to some other kind of data format, maybe? Or
you have two things. You have the encounter itself. So in the encounter itself, you put what is the presumptive diagnosis, and then if that presumptive diagnosis is confirmed, you will put it into the list of diseases of that person. And the other thing is what the patient relates to you. So if I come to your office and say, you know what, I had a history of appendicitis, I will tell you, and it's something that you will write on my personal history. It's not something that it was diagnosed by you. It's something that I'm relating to you, and you put it. And you know that that is done because you have the fact that I'm telling you this is not something that you discover in that encounter. You can import the data in different ways. They can send you the information on XML. As long as you have the fields that you need to be imported, you can do it for different models. That is one of them, the patient disease history. The other is the medications, you know. You can come to a well woman checkup and you can import what are your meds, or just input it manually. HL7 is one of the things that they will be needing it both for admissions and for prescription. So that's...
You mentioned the Android application there. Is the data encrypted? We had pushback in Ireland against them from the IT sector because there would be unencrypted data on tablets if left on a bus or something like that. Encryption platform.
Well, the Android, as far as I know, is just a client. No information, at least on this client, and Cedric and the Triton guys probably help me out here. The one that I'm talking about is just a client. You don't store stuff on that. But if you use SSL connection, I guess it would be encrypting the communication.
I think the red pad is built with a kind of local storage which synchronizes with the Python server.
There is one that does that. But we never were able to download But it was one that actually does the synchronization. It lets you work offline.
Yeah.
But the one I'm talking about is the one that the guys from BioEco Forest guys did. And it probably does that.
Perhaps, I don't know if it's stored in the, I don't know, the SD card or just in memory and just push at to reduce the communication
okay.
to the server. But so it, there is a kind of storage, but probably just in memory. But,
right.
Probably change.
But it's different as the other one does store data.
Because our use case would be nurses on calls with the tablet and recording mm-hmm. information directly.
I
said they put it on paper now and leave it in the back of the car.
I think that once the web client is mature enough, it probably will supersede. Because Android, I would like to have it going and customize,
yeah.
you know. Screens and views for the Android itself.
Yeah.
You know, like big things for blood pleasures and things that are going to be easily taken
yeah.
up.
Thank you.